चैप्टर 5 जुडिशरी
क्लास 8 पॉलिटी। यूनिट 3 टीचर्स नोट। ओके लेट्स स्टार्ट। अ ग्लांस एट द न्यूज़पेपर प्रोवाइड यू अ ग्लिम्स ऑफ द रेंज ऑफ वर्क डन बाय द कोर्ट्स इन दिस कंट्री। But can you think of why we need these courts? As you have read in Unit 2, in India we have the rule of law. What this means is that law apply equally to all persons and that a certain set of fixed procedures need to be followed when a law is violated. To enforce this rule of law, we have a judicial system that consists of the mechanism of court that a citizens can approach when a law is violated. As an organ of government, the judiciary plays a crucial role in the functioning of India's democracy. It can play this role only because it is independent. What does an independent judiciary mean? Is there any connection between the court in your area and the Supreme Court in New Delhi? In this chapter, you will find answer to these questions. Look at this is judiciary. What is the role of judiciary? Court takes decision on a very large number of issues. They can decide that no teacher can be beat a student, or the sharing of river waters between states, or they can punish people for particular crimes. Broadly speaking, the work that the judiciary does can be divided into the following. Disputing resolution. The judicial system provides a mechanism for resolving disputes between citizens, and the government, between two state governments, and between the center and state governments. Judicial review. As a final interpreter of the constitution, the judiciary also has the power to strike down particular laws passed by the parliament if it is believed that these are a violation of this basic structure of constitution. This is called judicial review. Upholding the law and enforcing fundamental rights. Every citizen of India can approach the Supreme Court or the High Court if they believe that their fundamental rights have been violated. For example, in class 7 book, you read about Hakim Sheikh, an agricultural laborer who fell from a running train and injured himself and whose condition got worse because several hospitals refused to admit him. On hearing his case, the Supreme Court ruled that Article 21, which provides every citizen the fundamental right to life, also includes that right to health. It therefore directed the West Bengal government to pay him compensation for the loss suffered, as well as to come up with a blueprint for primary health care, with particular reference to treatment of patients during an emergency. खेत मजदूर समिति वर्सेस स्टेट ऑफ वेस्ट बंगाल 1996। लुक एट द पिक्चर। द सुप्रीम कोर्ट वाज एस्टैब्लिश्ड ऑन 26 जनवरी 1950, द डे इंडिया बिकेम अ रिपब्लिक। लाइक इट्स प्रोसीजर्स, द फेडरल कोर्ट ऑफ इंडिया 1937 to 1949। इट वाज अर्लियर लोकेटेड इन द चैम्बर ऑफ प्रिंस इन द पार्लियामेंट हाउस। इट मूव टू इट्स प्रेजेंट बिल्डिंग ऑन Mathura Road in New Delhi 1958. Look at this. With the help of your teacher, fill in the blanks space in the table. Types of disputes, examples. Okay. What is an independent judiciary? Imagine a situation in which a powerful politician has encroached on land belonging to your family. Within this judicial system, the politician has the power to appoint and dismiss a judge from his office. When you take this case to court, the judge is clearly partial to the politicians. The control that the politician hold over the judge does not allow for the judge to take an independent decision. This lack of independence would force the judge and to make all judgment in favor of the politicians. Although we often hear of rich and powerful people in India trying to influence the judicial process, the Indian constitution protests against this kind of situation by providing for the independence of the judiciary. one respect of this independence is the separation of power. This, as you read chapter 1, is the key feature of the constitution. What this means here is that other branches of government, the legislature and the executive, cannot interfere in the work of judiciary. The court are not under the government and do not act as on their behalf. For the above separation to work well, it is also crucial that all judges in High Court as well as Supreme Court are appointed with very little interference from these other branches of government. Once appointed to this office, it is also very difficult to remove a judge. In this, it is the independence of judiciary that allows to the courts to play a central role in ensuring that there is no misuse of power by the legislature and the executive. It also plays a crucial role in protecting the fundamental rights of citizens, because anyone can approach the court if they believe that their rights have been violated. What is the structure of court in India? There are three different levels of courts in our country. There are several courts at the lower level, while there is only one at the apex level. The court that most people interact with are what are called subordinate or district courts. These are usually at the district or tehsil level, are in towns, and they hear many cases. Each state is divided into districts that are presided over by a district judge. Each state has a high court, which is the highest court of the state. At the top is the Supreme Court, that is located in New Delhi and is presided over by the Chief Justice of India. The decisions made by the Supreme Court are binding on all other courts in India. Look at the structure of courts from the lower to the highest. High Court were first established in the year presidency cities of Kolkata, Bombay and Madras in 1862. The High Court of Delhi came in 1966. Currently there are 25 courts, while many states have their own high courts. Punjab, Haryana share a common high court at Chandigarh, and four north eastern states of Assam, Nagaland, Mizoram, Arunachal Pradesh common high court at Guwahati. Andhra Pradesh, Amravati and Telangana, Hyderabad have separate high courts from 1 January 2019. Some high courts have benches in other part of the state. The greater accessibility. Are these different level of courts connected to each other? Yes, they are. In India, we have an integrated judicial system, meaning that the decision made by higher courts are binding on the lower courts. Another way to understand this integration is through the appellate system that exists in India. This means that a person can appeal to a higher court if they believe that the judgment passed by the lower courts is not just. Let us understand what we mean by the appellate system. By tracking a case, State Delhi Administrations versus Lakshman Kumar and others, 1985, from the lower courts to the Supreme Court. In February 1980, Lakshman Kumar and married 20-year-old Sudha Goyal, and they lived in a flat in New Delhi. Lakshman's brother and their families. On 2 December 1980, Sudha died in hospital due to burns. Her family filed a case in courts. When this case was heard in trial court, four of her neighbors were called in witnesses. They stated that on the night of December 1, they had heard Sudha scream and had forced their way into Lakshman's flat. There they saw Sudha standing with her sari in flames. They extinguished
the fire by wrapping Sudha in a gunny bag and a blanket. Sudha told them that her mother-in-law Shakuntala had poured kerosene oil on her and that her husband Lakshman had lit the fire. During the trial, members of Sudha's family and a neighbor stated that Sudha had been subjected to torture by her in-laws and that they were demanding more cash, a scooter and a freeze on the birth of the first child. As part of their defense, Lakshman and his mother stated that Sudha's sari had accidentally caught fire while she was heating milk. On the basis of this and other evidence, the trial court convicted Lakshman, his mother Shakuntala and his brother-in-law Subhash Chandra and sentenced all three of them to death. Aizawl Mizoram bench of the Guwahati High Court, look at the picture. And in November 1983, the three accused went to High Court to appeal against this verdict of trial court. The High Court, after hearing the argument of all the lawyers, decided that Sudha had died due to an accidental fire caused by the kerosene stove. Lakshman, Shakuntala and Subhash Chandra were acquitted. You may remember the photo easy on the women's movement in your class 7 book. You read about how in the 1980s women group across the country spoke out against dowry death. They protested against the failure of the court of bring these cases to justice. The above High Court judgment deeply troubled women and they held demonstrations and filed a separate appeal against this High Court decision in the Supreme Court through the Indian Federation of Women Lawyers. In 1985, the Supreme Court heard this appeal against the acquittal of Lakshman and two members of his family. The Supreme Court heard the argument of the lawyer and reached a decision that was different from that of the High Court. They found Lakshman and his mother guilty but acquitted the brother-in-law Subhash because they did not have enough evidence against him. The Supreme Court decided to send the accused to prison for life. Look at the picture. District Courts complex in Namchi, South Sikkim. Thank you.